After hitting a record low in President Biden's first year in office, while white-collar prosecutions from the Department of Justice have slowly started to increase, the only problem is the worst offenders keep getting away with it. That's the story, right? Pick up the story. Yeah. Do you remember after the burndown, financial burndown, the Wall Street stole $8 trillion from mom and pop? And then we had Obama comes in, oh, I'm going to do something about this. This is going to stop and some people are going to be prosecuted. You remember that?
Yep.
It's one reason I jump. Do you remember me getting up first thing in the morning, going on Fox News of all places to defend Obama because I was so convinced that he was going to do something meaningful about all this? I mean, that was my talking point. How do we not do something about this? Time after time we heard that was his point. Not just him, but virtually every president that runs. We're going to do something. We're going to clean up the white-collar criminal problem in this country.
Yeah.
Well, do you know what? After that was done, he let virtually everybody go. Nobody, none of those bankers, not one single banker went to prison. The documents and the conduct was overwhelming. I mean, it was criminality from top to bottom. Everybody walked free. It's just the new norm, isn't it?
It is. And, you know, on top of that, a couple years into Obama's administration, we had the BP Deepwater Horizon.
Good, I forgot about
Obama came out and said, "You just tell me who's ass to kick." Those are his exact words. Tell me who's ass to kick.
Right.
Well, nobody got their ass kicked. Everybody got off scot-free, even with all of the horrible things we learned. And this cycle just continues itself. And so, you know, this story comes out. It says, hey, look, we've actually had an uptick in white-collar prosecutions. The DOJ actually prosecuted 9 more people.
Not 90, but 9.
9 more than we did the year before. So, hey, we're winning. But then, as Public Citizen points out, you look at the numbers and you realize, wait a minute. You're not actually prosecuting the big corporate people. You're prosecuting small business owners.
Put that in perspective.
People with less than 50 employees, you're going after the little local pizza joint on the corner, but you call that a corporate prosecution. Meanwhile, you've got the bankers, you've got the Boeing CEOs, you've got the pharma CEOs. They're killing people. And, oh, well, we like them, but yeah, we're going to get the little, you know, clothing shop around the corner.
76% of the prosecutions were for corporations that had fewer than 50 employees, okay? The rest of the prosecutions, there weren't any. I mean, you know, if you had 1,000 employees, you got something called deferred prosecution. Explain to the viewers what that means.
Yeah, this is basically the slap on the wrist. That is the DOJ coming to you and saying, listen, we know deep down you're good people, so we're not gonna hold you accountable. There's gonna be a fine. You know, so give us some money, and that's what the DOJ loves their fund money, and they get to spend that money that they bring in. That is essentially their big piggy bank, and so they would rather get the money, buy themselves, you know, new offices, new company cars, new computers.
Cool SUVs.
Exactly.
And
that is what they do, because we've done that story too, but then these companies say, okay, well, we won't do it again. 2 years later, they'll be back in front of those DOJ lawyers saying, okay, we did it again. Well, don't worry, because I know you've got those big government contracts. So once again, here's your other fine, and don't do it again that we can see.
Because they look like exactly the guy, the sociopath, sitting across the table from them.
Yeah.
Okay? The sociopath who makes decisions, we're going to kill 150 people a day with opioids, knowing it's going to kill 150 people. That we're going to allow Roundup to kill thousands of people all over the country. We're going to allow a talcum powder that's infected with asbestos to kill thousands of people. All these people get away genuinely with murder, but they look like the folks at the DOJ. They're dressed up in suits. They have white shirts on. They went to Harvard and Yale. And the guy at the DOJ says, you know, if I play my cards right, maybe I can get a job here. And then the guy working for a career says, I don't need to spend any time doing this. Hell, I'm going to make whatever I make by not doing anything.
Yeah, and then meanwhile, you've got the little pizza joint around the corner. The guy that owns it lets his 13-year-old kid run the cash register for a couple hours, and they'll pop him for child labor violations and prosecute him and say, look at what we've done. White-collar prosecutions are through the roof because we got 9 extra small business owners behind bars.
Yeah, like that's a big victory.
Yeah.
Until you put them in prison, this culture will never change.
Yep.
Is if you let them, HSBC, I just wrote a book, it's called Suspicious Activity, where these big banks were washing money for terrorists and drug cartels, okay? Washing money. HSBC admitted doing it. They signed a document. Yes, we did it. We knew what we were doing. We made billions of dollars. We knew soldiers were going to be killed. Contractors were going to be killed. We did it anyway. You know what the Eric Holder did with that? Fined them $1.6 billion. They made $100 billion. Fined them $1.6 billion. Like, that was a big victory. Like, oh boy, we really made them pay. Nobody went to prison. And that's the new norm in this country right now. You just can't shake that new norm.
Helped dirty money flow through its branches around the world, including at least 800...
Plaintiffs allege that the defendants provided money and medical goods to terrorist groups Hezbollah and Jaish al-Mahdi.
This is a well-organized business for these individuals that carry out these attacks. Terrorism is a business, and they run it like a business.
They knew about what was going on for a decade. They absolutely, no question about it, knew that HSBC was washing money. They had every reason to understand it was for terrorism and it was for drug cartels. Took no action whatsoever.
These banks are involved. Their accounts are connected and they're using them to mask the transactions. The more complicated they can make the transactions, the more distance they can put between the bad guys and the seemingly legitimate purpose of these funds.
They pay $1.9 billion, which is a drop in the bucket compared to what they've made. And nobody goes to prison. These CEOs, these bankers that made this decision, they're safe at home. They know what they've done. It's resulted in the death of Americans, contractors and soldiers, not just hundreds, but thousands. And we look the other way because they don't look like criminals. The die is cast. The people that are responsible for are on Wall Street.
And they don't look like criminals. It's almost a suspension of disbelief. Sometimes I'll have people call me and say, is this real? Do they really get away with this? Yeah, they do.